today is the fifth day of the fifth month on our Maker's restored calendar. It is the 25th day of the sixth month on his servant Satan's calendar. The Most High has continued to send forth his consecutive daily shakings on the Big Island of Hawaii. As of yesterday's 5.2, the total number of days of these consecutive shakings that have all originated from volcanic eruptions is 15. I did not log back onto the internet today before recording this video to see if he has already sent forth a 16th such consecutive shaking today. Perhaps he has. Yesterday's 15th shaking was the second 5.2 in a row. The Hebrew language doubles things in order to put an emphasis upon them. Perhaps he will even triple these 5.2s. Or perhaps he will go back to causing them to be 5.3s. He sent forth the first of these dual 5.2s at 7:34 p.m. on the third day of the fifth month, according to the time zone that it is at his house that he has raised up in the midst of the chief seat of Mystery Babylon at this time. This 7:34 waypoint was exactly 96 days after his 7:34 p.m. waypoint on the 27th day of the first month. This 7:34 p.m. mark in time on 1/27 on his restored calendar symbolized the end of the 84 hours of my death. 96 parallels the 96 pomegranates of 100 that remained upon each of the four rows of them that were upon the dual crowns of the dual pillars Yakin and Boaz. These dual pillars represent his dual sons of his anointing oil. 5-3 was the first day of the 52 days that it took Nehemiah and company to finish building the wall. They finished building it on 6/25. The Most High is causing this video to go forth on 6/25 on his servant Satan's calendar. A couple of years ago, he caused me to produce a video that was called Outer Darkness that spoke about how there were only 29 days in the fifth month when they built up this wall. This endeavor followed his Feast of Sevens that is on the day that follows his servant Moses' 40th night on Mount Horeb. According to the 30 days that are in each month on his restored calendar, 5-3 is the sixth day from Moses' 40th day. Recently I've spoken that I thought that this sixth day might be the sixth day of his after 6 days prophecy. What he sent forth on yesterday's seventh day that followed this six-day waypoint was beyond amazing. He sent forth an eighth messenger of blood and the fulfillment of an incredible prophecy that involves all of the wine that is left at his house. The third day of the fifth month's 7:34 p.m. 5.2 shaking that occurred on the 96th day mark from this waypoint in time on 1/27 was the 100th night of him causing his beloved to not drink wine. Perhaps it is a coincidence that there were only 96 pomegranates of the 100 of them that were originally upon each of the four rows of them that were upon the dual crowns of the dual pillars Yakin and Boaz at the time that Nebuchadnezzar's army broke them down. During these 100 days, he has brought a nine nights supply of wine to his house. However, I have not drank any of this short-term supply until last night. I did so last night, the night of the fourth day of the fifth month, because his word told me that I was to do so. I will explain how his word told me to do so in a bit. It is beyond incredible. These nine nights supply parallel the 9 months that it takes to bring forth a child from the womb of after conception. There are 7 seventh-day Sabbaths during the 52 days that our ancestors built up the wall. There are also 7 seventh-day Sabbaths in the first leg of his dual part count to his Feast of Sevens. Since there were only 29 days in the fifth month at that time, they also ceased from this endeavor on one head of the month day. Therefore, there were 8 days that they did not do any work on this wall, and 44 days that they did. Now that his 30-day months are restored, there are 9 non-work days during this period of time that is now 53 days according to his restored calendar instead of 52 days, since there are always 2 head-of-the-month days on his restored calendar. These 9 non-work days during this period of time also parallel the 9 months of pregnancy. Perhaps it is a coincidence that there are always also 53 days that are in the first leg of his dual part count to his Feast of Sevens now that he has restored his 30-day months. The Hebrew word for the river Chebar is used 17 times in the testimony of his word. These 17 times parallel the 17 shekels of his Jeremiah chapter 32 prophecy. This word is used 8 times in his end time Son of Adam prophecies, and it is used 9 times in the book of Ecclesiastes. The 9 times that it is used in the book of Ecclesiastes testify that this word means that which has already happened. In light of these 8 non-work days turning into 9 on his restored calendar, perhaps these 8 and 9 times of 17 are a coincidence. I will go on in a bit to explain how it looks like perhaps yesterday's 8th messenger of blood is going to bring an end to the first of the 3 overlapping 9-month periods of time that are going on in the Shulamite's womb. During the dawning hours of the night of 5-3, before I rose up from my tent, he caused me to have a dream vision that involved an archery convention of sorts. When his Isaiah chapter 8 prophetess walked by my tent yesterday morning to go milk the dual goats of his Isaiah chapter 7 prophecy, I asked how she was doing, and she said that she was good, and then she asked me how I was doing, and I answered that I was very tired. The reason that I was tired is because it had been 100 consecutive nights of me not sleeping well. He has caused me to have a condition that causes me to not sleep well unless I have some wine to drink before I retire for the evening. This Shulamite then told me that she had just read a psalm that tells me that he gives sleep to his beloved. This is found in his Psalms chapter 127 prophecy. This prophecy tells us the following in the 5 verses of it. It's titled the 8th, or the Song of the Steps of Solomon. It's the 8th song of the 15 steps to Solomon. Verse 1, if Yahweh does not build the house, the builders of it, they labor in futility. If Yahweh does not hedge about the city, the watchman guards it in futility. It is futility, or it is meaningless, for you to rise up to the early risers of those that sit as the deferrers, referring to those that hold back from obeying his voice, of the eaters of the bread of the toils. Therefore he is giving sleep to his beloved. Perhaps it is a coincidence that I lay upon my cot in the mornings meditating upon things before I get up each morning. Behold, children are the heritage of Yahweh, and the fruit of the womb is his reward. As arrows are in the hand of the mighty, so are children of the early years. Happy is the valiant man that has his quiver filled of them. They will not be ashamed because they will speak with the enemies in the gate. This Shulamite did not know that I had the dream vision that involved the archery convention that morning when she read this psalm and then told me about it. Perhaps it is a coincidence that there are 4 children, including Maher-shalal-hash-baz, that are growing in her womb. Perhaps it is a coincidence that yesterday's anniversary of the 850 loaves of gold and silver being brought into the depository of his house was 127 days after the second of the dual waypoints that were over the course of a 3-day period of time that his word gives to us for raising up the king of Judah from prison. This day being the 7th day after 6 days caused me to consider that perhaps he is giving me the go-ahead to drink some wine. As I considered this, he caused me to look at something that he had recorded in Nehemiah chapter 5. He told us the following in verse 18. And that which was done for me in one day was one bullock and six purifieds of the flock and fowls that were done for me, and between 10 of days in all of the wine to be increased. And with this I did not seek the bread of the governor, because the service is honored upon this people. What is told to us in this verse is beyond amazing. Last week, before the feast, the Shulamite and I were in town to get a radiator for the truck that he has provided for us, and we ran into the local rancher that grazes his cattle around us. This man and his family are of the very few people that have extended kindness to us. I told him about what Kikwe is doing in sending forth Maher-shalal-hash-baz and his siblings at this time, and after I did so, he asked us if we have found any arrowheads, of all things, up here, and that he would trade meat for them if we had. Perhaps he knew that I was going to have yesterday's archery dream ahead of time. This man had no idea that we had not had any meat of the bullock to eat for well over a year when he said this, nor that this feast was coming up. I told him that we had found a spearhead and I think one arrowhead, and that we would be happy to trade them for some meat. While we were working on the truck in the parking lot, he ran home and he brought us back a roast from a bullock that we ate for the one day of the feast. This one day of eating this bullock was the first day of these 6 days that took us to yesterday's seventh day. Was Yahweh finishing purifying me during these 6 days? As I meditate upon my bed in the mornings, the fowls of his dual heavens are singing all around us and the ravens are speaking to us. This was also the case yesterday morning while I was having this archery dream. Between 10 of days of all of the wine is the 9 nights supply of wine that we have here. Coincidence, I'm sure. Perhaps it is also a coincidence that there were 10 days that encompassed yesterday and his first messenger of blood delivery waypoint. This verse telling us that this 9 night supply of all of the wine that is here is going to be increased leads me to think that perhaps he is going to begin to bring the heaps into the depository of his house at the end of this 10-day period of time. And with this I did not seek the bread of the governor, because the service is honored upon this people, is speaking about me not speaking to you in a smooth way that would have caused you to sustain his anointed like the false shepherds of Israel speak to you. I have not sought your approval, and this is why you continue stealing from him. This is also why his word tells us that I will not be bribed. This service being honored upon you is speaking of Yahweh honoring your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts in causing you to continue stealing from him while he has shortened the days of his wrath through his chosen one. This is why Nehemiah went on in the next verse to tell us, Yahweh marked me for good according to all that I have done for this people. As a result of your stealing from him, the dual wives of his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy and the dual men that are standing with his anointed and I have carried the burden of him holding back, letting loose his wrath. One of the 9 places that the word Chabar is used in Ecclesiastes tells us the following in Ecclesiastes 9:7. Journey forth eating your bread with glee and drinking your wine with a good heart, because Elohim Chabars, or he has already delightfully accepted your works. Yesterday's wine-drinking waypoint was the 97th day from 127. Perhaps his telling us this in chapter 9, verse 7 is a coincidence. The next verse goes on to tell us that he is speaking about one that is always clothed in white garments, whose head never lacks being anointed. 7 of the 8 places that his word references the river Chabar are in his fifth day of the fourth month prophecy, and in his fifth day of the sixth month prophecy. And the eighth place that he does so is referring to these dual prophecies that speak of the four living creatures. Perhaps it's a coincidence that there are four children in her womb. Perhaps it is also a coincidence that he has caused the Shulamite to begin to have her eighth messenger of blood on yesterday's wine-drinking waypoint. He sent forth his seventh messenger of blood nearly three complete 28-day cycles earlier on 4/11 on his servant Satan's calendar. He sent forth Operation Grapes of Wrath on 4/11/1996 on his servant Satan's calendar. 28 days is four sevens. Three sets of these four sevens of a woman's cycle are 84 days, paralleling the 84 hours that his dual sons of his anointing oil are dead. The 12 sevens that are in these 84 days parallel the 12 rods of Israel. Yesterday's eighth messenger of blood was 74 days after his seventh messenger of blood, paralleling the 74 days of his account of the flood. He caused the heads of the mountains to begin to break through the surface of the waters 74 days after he marked his servant Noah. When a woman gives birth, her waters break and a head surfaces from her womb. 74 days is 10 days short of 84 days, paralleling the 10 days of yesterday's anniversary of the 850 loaves of gold and silver being brought into the depository of his house that they brought forth. And also the 10 days, his prophecies are for 10 days in prison. All of these details are placing a great deal of significance upon his first messenger of blood delivery waypoint that is at the end of these 10 days, that is at 3 a.m. on July 4th, according to his servant Satan's calendar. Since this eighth issue of blood began after sunrise yesterday, today is day number one of her uncleanliness. This will put her eighth day when she is clean on the 12th day of the fifth month. She will be clean for 2 days, and then towards the end of the 13th day of this month, we will have reached his first messenger of blood delivery waypoint, and it is looking like the 80 days of her uncleanliness that results from the birth of a female child might very well begin. Therefore, these 2 days set up a very real possibility for the fulfillment of his prophecy that is for him keeping his anointed and my family alive for 2 more days, and then him raising us up to live before his faces on the 3rd day. Him sending forth these 9 nights of wine and his 8th messenger of blood on the same day parallels his turning the waters of his statutes into his only begotten son's shed blood. He caused his only begotten son to turn the waters that were put into the 6 stone pots. I'll repeat that. That were put into the 6 stone pots that were used for purifying. I will repeat that. That were used for purifying into wine. And then to later speak that the wine is symbolic of his blood as a foreshadow of this. The significance that his word places upon the 8th day with things like a man-child being circumcised on the 8th day and a woman being clean on the 8th day and his 8th day Sabbath that follows his feast of ingathering has been discussed throughout these videos. There is more to all of this that adds to the incredible significance of him sending forth the blood and the wine on yesterday's 7th day. However, I am going to end this video here today. It indeed looks like the final 10 days of my being bound are at hand.